Hello everybody and welcome back to Zone of the Enders, the second runner. Apparently you should not save here. Because remember last time, this is where I saved, right? I don't remember walking in there. I could be completely wrong, but wherever I saved last time at the end of the video, don't save there. Because I had to start all the way from the beginning where this door wasn't unlocked and that was all fun. And since I'm fully healed and don't know if I can come back for that Metatron, I'm just going to leave it there and hope I can come back for it later if I need it. Door's closed, of course. Boss fight?
Viola,
boss fight.
You're already here.
I found you.
Oh goody. If I remember correctly, I do not remember how to fight this boss. Oh yeah, here we go.
If you can guard against the enemy slamming in, you might be able to nullify the enemy shield.
So an ordinary guard cannot be used.
If you have some sort of catalyst, you can improve Jehuti's abilities.
A catalyst?
Please search for something like a board as a guard.
Huh, right. Something over there. Oh, I can't zoom in.
Let's do it.
So, what I was planning on doing wasn't going to work. Okay, so what you need to do, all around this area, and what I forgot, I'm not even close to one because it's not even locking on, but these pads, panels here, you can actually pick up. And if you guard, you can, like said, amplify the guard. Also looks at, like if you're close and use a burst attack, grab. Ooh, that was close. Basically all you're having to do is run away, wait until she dashes at you, and guard. Well, apparently she ran into something herself. Come on. Dash it at you, use that as a guard, and hit her hard, and then run. Because everything in this game loves hitting hard. Yeah, nope, can't even. Yeah, even if she bounces her face off the wall, you have to physically guard, because it'll break the shielding around her so you can actually hit her. I think I did some damage there. I forget if this fight stays this repetitive. Which I mean is okay, because it's not that hard. But I'm really hoping it doesn't actually change, because my luck, it changes to something completely difficult and I'd have to retry the fight about 15 times. I'm looking at you, Leo. Got it. Shield's back up. At least there's enough panels to use as a shield. Up and halfway through, something's gonna change. Is there gonna be a part two, or does that just force us into a different situation? Right into a shield. And again, everything makes the frickin' controller vibrate in the cutscenes. Okay, if I remember correctly, just dodge. She'll run into the shield that's around you, and that will break her shield, and that'll allow you to hit her. But don't be an idiot like I was just there for a second and get hit yourself by the force field, I guess is a better way to put it. Okay, just back up. It's better to take as many hits as you can against her. and back up instead of getting caught in the shield. Dash. See? I even tried to back away, but no! Jehu has to get that final blow in. Crap. Crap! Get off the... Was she shooting me into the wall or something? Oh! Ooh, saved yourself there. Come on. You know you want to go face first into this. Gotcha. Not done yet. Looks like two more. And those little energy bullets or whatever you want to call it. Come on. Oh! Okay, it was enough. Somehow I knocked her back into it and took out the rest of her health. Goody, what ability did we get?
We obtained the device driver for the sub-weapon...
Ooh!
This is a weapon with great enemy homing capabilities.
The attack that I spammed the last game. Good. Let's start spamming again.
When I was with Barum, Viola was the last person I wanted as an enemy.
The enemy is a battle AI that will never stop following a target while the target continues to exist.
If it's modeled after Viola, it's so much the worse. Ada, is this the settlement?
There are life signs in many buildings.
We have come to the worst place. Let's leave.
Hey, Henry G! Have you already arrived on Mars?
Who is this?
Oh, God.
It's Piper. We met on Deimos.
Are you still alive? That's a miracle, isn't it?
I received a transmission from the Eight Heads platoon on the coast.
Are they a Lev unit with the vector cannon?
Yeah. They seem to be stuck and confined in a facility by a cliff. I'm going to the point of origin of the dispatch now.
I'll be there soon.
Hey, by the way, what is your mission?
What's going on there?
Gotta love the timing. Everything, seriously! Them stepping made my controller vibrate. Those shots, not even close to Jehudi, making the controller vibrate. Seriously.
All teams, move in formation 2. Meet again after the enemy is exterminated.
Stand by.
Stand by.
Hey, Taper, they seem like your pals, don't they?
Why didn't you say our pals? Don't you know them?
Ada, put me through to that unit.
This is Storm Company.
What are you doing? Do you want to involve civilians?
Who cares? Anyhow, they're only the small fry of Vasilia.
Hey, what?
He must be really upset. Henry G, please help them.
Damn! Taper, there's no guarantee, though.
Please.
Storm Company, I'm coming to help.
Who is this?
Don't talk too much. Ada!
Which are you going to help? The Space Force or civilian buildings?
Both!
All right. The damage percentage of the people in the civilian buildings is shown on the radar. Please eliminate the entire enemy before they are completely destroyed. One more thing. The Space Force's Levs are manned. Be careful not to destroy them.
What do I do when I want a Lev to stop attacking the building?
You will employ the sub-weapon, Geyser.
Sure, I can stop them moving with Geyser. Ada, you're good at your job for a battle AI.
My previous runner influenced me greatly.
That must be that Leo I met.
He always had respect for human life.
You're the type that behaves the way the man you love wants you to.
God damn it.
I do not comprehend.
Thank you,
Ada. I have to. It will all end when I dispose of Barom's unmanned machine. Anyway, let's go.
Certainly.
Every time, gotta bring that AI human love into this. Okay, so, got another save the people mission. At least the enemies aren't that strong. I can kind of get away with just pecking them off pretty easily like this. Oh, cool, I got a level up from this. So I'm now even like, I think I'm 3 levels stronger than the the spider enemies here. Yeah, with the spider enemies, it's just easier to get in close because you can do more damage that way. I think if you just go straight up and finish most of them off quickly, none of the levs will actually attack any of the buildings. All the buildings are behind me right now. So me shooting that direction was not a good thing. I think all the survivors are here, towards this area. That was not a good move, but sometimes the controls are just too simple to do certain things, like that dash attack. Quit standing on the building. Probably use grab to get rid of most of these guys pretty simply. Or use comet and just one-shot them, probably. There we go, that was three of them down.
What are you doing?
Hitting you too, because you're in my way. You're... son of a monkey.
Be careful.
Ooh, what's this? Oh, sub energy. Okay, that's just to refill sub energy. Good. Great. That's exactly what I wanted to know. Why aren't you locking onto the enemy? Not the. Why even allow me to lock onto the levs? Seriously, game. Well, I guess it'd be easier to pull off things like, oh, shoot them with geyser. But I really feel like the lock-on reticle should really focus on the enemies. Just so I'm not sitting there almost about ready to shoot and end up shooting one of the levs and they get mad at me like happened a little bit earlier. Don't shoot. Here's a time to grab. Grab. Since these guys won't... Okay, good, throw. But whenever they're close to a building, just grab them, find one that's not close to a building like that, and just throw it.
Pay attention to the buildings.
I know, Ada. Thing is, can't pay attention to the buildings and try to save everybody at the same time. They're shooting at, hold on, I need to. Thank you. Hold on. I know.
What were you trying to do?
This.
What is this? It won't move at all.
Lock on, please. Thank you for finally finding a spider. No, back to the spider. Okay, how many more? This is impossible. This is going to be fan-friggin-tastic. Don't shoot close to the buildings. These guys are going to be the death of me. I'm probably going to end up getting a failing mark. Ooh. Just because these guys don't know how to friggin' save a building without missing 100 times. Or getting a better angle to where they don't shoot towards the building at all. Where's the grab? You're coming with me. You too. There we go. That was a nice grab. Grabbed him out of the air. This is just the easiest way to... Aw, oh, son of a... I shouldn't have thrown it.
Be careful.
Trying to. Game? Don't want to keep saying that. Stop locking on to the... Stop auto-locking onto the ally and only auto-lock onto the enemies. That would help, but no matter what happens, if the enemy that you're locked on is destroyed... Nice spin. But if the enemy you're locked on is destroyed somehow, and the closest thing to lock on is an ally, it locks onto the ally. It's annoying when you don't want to shoot them.
Mission completed.
I could have saved more of them.
Oh, wow, I got a B.
In that situation, this is a realistic figure.
I don't care about figures. Too many people have been killed.
But if it weren't for you, there would have been more destruction.
Are you trying to ease my mind?
I got a B somehow. In the last game, that would have been a friggin' F. So I will take that B.
What are you doing? Don't butt in at our battle.
A battle? Does the Space Force call massacring innocent civilians battle?
I don't care about Vasilia's people. They're nothing. It doesn't matter whether they're civilians or not. It's still the same.
Shut up! If you say anything more, I'm gonna kill you, you wretch.
What?
Go away.
Take the warning.
Please put me through to Leo.
All right, I will put you through to Leo Stenbuck.
Dingo, what's wrong?
How has your search for the Levs been going?
I've already saved several people, but they all say they would attack Amon.
They were ordered to, weren't they?
But it's impossible for Levs to attack Barom.
Let them do as they like.
You're heartless, aren't you? If they're your ally...
Is the Space Force my ally? Don't kid me.
What?
Hey, I found a few Lev units in the civilian residential area near the South Gate. If you still think they're your team, you can pick them up.
All right.
Ada, put me through to Taper.
All right, I will put you through.
Henry G, how's everything going?
I did my best.
Your pals destroyed about 5 buildings.
Yeah, I've confirmed the vector cannon too, but things are worse.
What's wrong?
This location might have been discovered by Barom.
What? Where is it?
This is an energy facility along Ayers Cliff. It seems to be supplying power for Aumon.
Wait, the enemy is approaching.
Oh good, what kind of enemy barges into a cutscene like that? Oh.
What?
The Naritas. I would love to be on that train, though. That looks like a heck of a train. Just floating a couple feet off the ground.
Where is the train going?
It is going via Ayers Cliff along the sea.
They're attacking all the way. Hey, Taper! The train carrying the orbital frame is going towards you.
What's that?
I'll destroy it before it gets there.
Is that right?
After all, it's just on the way.
Ada, after all, it's the estimated just time on the way. Arrival.
Roger.
You are a cocky, cocky person. And that's why I like your character. So much more fun than Leo. And I just realized something. Starting this off, oh god, I'm probably gonna have to stop and save because this is gonna take a long time. Been going so well in this video. And through a boss fight, got through the next area.
I destroyed from the rear and worked my way to the front.
Okay, so basically, I'm just gonna save right here if I can. And attempt to do this? But I don't know how well I'll be able to do this because it's kind of supposed to be... It's gonna be a long, drawn out thing. Because you have to destroy the train all the way through. And of course, it can't just be so easy that you destroy the train. No, the train attacks back. Why am I throwing the geyser? Get back to something useful. Wow, that looks completely different from what it used to. You're getting annoying now, you stupid little beams. These are the type of beams that Jehudi should just be able to shake off, but no, everything in this game has a little bit of knockback. And that's what makes me mad. The smallest of beams are the most annoying because they are most likely rapid fire. And once you get hit by one, you can't really dodge real well. So you're going to get hit by the rest. Come on. Oh, good. And since I don't have any weapon energy, these guys are going to be... They're sub-weapon energy. These guys are going to be a little bit of a pain. And I also don't have that much health. Let me switch back to grab so I can actually do something Good. That worked out really well. Oh, now we have big lasers. Crap. Again, this is one of those moments where I really wish they had some sort of healing somewhere, because I'm already low on health, and there's probably no way I'm going to survive everything at this rate. Okay, it actually looks like you're... No, you can still go faster. I thought it looked like JUD was automatically dashing, but... No, not exactly. You can still technically dash. It'd be nice if JUD was just automatically dashing in this area, because it'd make dodging a little bit easier. Oh, good. More Naritas. You stay there. I'm going to throw you a buddy. Never mind. I'm going to throw him a buddy. Go hit the wall. At least once they go far enough away, they don't count as enemies anymore, technically. They're too far away to catch up again, I guess. But this is where I really wish there was some health, because I'm so low on energy that that beam's probably going to kill me in one shot. If I can just... This isn't even the last one, either. There's a couple more that I have to get rid of. Looks like I can... Ah, come on! Come on. Just give me a couple of seconds. Quit hitting me with that small, stupid little beam. Should have just stuck with me multiple lasers instead of trying to charge. Can't blame me for trying, at least. And there it is.
You talked big, didn't you? I'm disappointed in you, Henry G.
Well, what are you doing, sitting there waiting for me? So, shut up. Okay, I think I'm back up to the one that I was killed at, and I figured out a little bit of a trick. Don't charge for long on the ball attack. Just charge as much as you need to actually use it, and just use it in one shot, because it does enough damage to destroy at least one, if not multiple, at a time. And it damages the surrounding ones enough to where, if that, you only have to shoot once or twice. And then, right after you destroy them all, charge and fire. Because all the enemies are spawned in, they teleport in at the same place. What the hell's shooting at me? This little stupid... They have all the combinations. They have the giant beams, they have the small beams, they have everything. Just a little tap, basically. Dodge enough. And just... Thought I had enough time there. Go. Dodge. Okay, I think I got rid of the big beams. But I just love this. Okay, once this one's destroyed, boom, charge up. And fire. They're all close together, so they're all going to take damage. And they're probably going to go down to at least half health, if not kill them outright. Ugh. And I think the front carriage doesn't have any weapons on it. And there we go. That was a lot easier than I made it look the first time. Oh, wow. If you could have stopped that like that, why can't I use that super strength to my advantage? Seriously. Let's just stop 4, 5, 6 train carts.
We obtained the sub-weapon, Decoy.
Oh, we got the decoy now.
This is a copy of Jehuti and confuses the enemy's radar.
Taper?
That will most likely be helpful in the next battle.
Dingo?
It's you.
I've just arrived on Mars. You know, they know where the Lev team and the Vector Cannon are.
I know.
Yes.
I'm coming near it, too.
I'll catch you soon.
Noman will find you.
It's all right. Now he's crazy about activating Almon.
When I was in Noman's unit, one of the team was a spy from the Space Force.
Huh?
For some months, no one in the unit suspected him. Not even me.
And then?
But only Noman suspected. I don't know why.
What happened to this guy?
No idea. Next day, I saw his left hand in the garbage.
Did it come off when they shook hands?
Stop acting tough.
You are joking, aren't you? It's not funny, though.
No. Since nothing happened to you while working alongside Noman, I can't believe that you're a real spy from the Space Force.
So?
Tell me the truth. What are you?
You don't trust me, do you?
Are you surprised?
Let me tell you something. You concealed yourself after the final mission. What were you doing after that?
It's none of your business.
If you wished, you could have returned to Bahram.
Stop it.
You made up your mind to hide out in Callisto, and you left your comrades to their fate. Isn't that right?
Shut up!
Do you think I can trust such a man? You're just another. Even so, I still trust you.
Huh?
Even now, I hear rumors about you. When you were in Bahram, you were not only an excellent runner, but also popular with your pals. They said that only you could match Noman, so I revived you.
And tried to use me.
If you had returned to Bahram and stopped Noman, things would have been different.
Easy to say.
I'm also trying to...
You always depend on others to make it, don't you?
I came to Mars, didn't I?
It's Tabor. I'll hang up.
Henry G., did you make it?
I already stopped the train. And you?
I'm Ellie Caton, a platoon subleader of the Eight Heads. I thank you for your support.
Yeah. Any casualties?
Nothing serious, but everyone is exhausted. We need your help.
Don't let them move. Space Force, they're all the same. Hey, Taper!
You came much closer than I expected, didn't you? Orbital frames are fast indeed.
Huh?
Something's approaching. Is that you?
No, I'm still...
What the hell?!
Take position! Pull back! Pull back!
Taper, what's going on?
Such speed.
Oh, God!
Assumptions, Anubis. This is the most obvious guess. And this cutscene's still going? Oh no, I think it's actually switching to gameplay here. Which is good, because I need to save. I forget, this is a Kojima game. Why did I think this having long cutscenes was strange? I should be... That's just stupid of me to think, oh, wait a minute, Kojima has long cutscenes? Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a like and think about subscribing, and I will see you guys next time.